iron armor, and I've still got an absolute mess out the front here. We're not off to a great start. I really want to get geared up today, and I want to take care of this. And I've been thinking, how do I deal with that creeper? Well, maybe we should just make a bow and shoot it. The thing is, I've only got literally one arrow, but because we've been working with the villagers, we now have infinity bows available to us. So I'm going to have an infinity bow to defend myself with. And as you might have seen, I've got some diamonds. One of the recurring things people keep talking about this season and this update is that diamonds seem to be harder to come by, and I've been at it for hours down there. This is all I've got, like 16 diamond ore, so we're going to have to break that down and see what we can make out of that. Hopefully we can get ourselves some diamond armor and maybe a diamond sword as well. So, it has taken some time, a lot of trial and error, but inside of here it looks fantastic. However, not the top part, I'm talking about the part down the bottom. So, first of all, we've got a place to set our spawn, we've got a little balcony here, and then if you drop down into this area, oh, it really kind of like opens up with the details, right? So, we got the enchanting area, we got our storage, and I wanted this to look, you know, variated sort of semi-organic, I guess. So, I've thrown in some blocks next to the barrels to represent what's going to be inside of them, and this will continue to evolve as we go along here. The best thing in this room, though, apart from all the tiny little details that you can probably spot, like throwing in the occasional texture, this bit was so much fun to put together, and you'll notice that these blocks are directly above the chest. We can't actually open these ones nice like that, so then we branch mining and whatnot, and if we go off in this direction and around the corner, this leads us to the geode, and because I've been working on all that other stuff, you can see the crystals are now forming on all sides of the blocks. So once you've ripped out all the other ones, this place becomes far more productive. And then in the opposite direction, up and down, I actually died twice and I have 33 levels of experience. So painful, I know. Because what we're going to do now is use this to get some experience points, do some enchanting, finally get some good things together. And while we do that, we are going to decorate this area here, of course. But I have got my 33 levels of experience back, which is just fantastic. We're ready to do some enchanting. And the last time that I mined diamonds, I had 3 of them and I got 3 diamonds. Those using my fortune pick. So we're doing this one on camera, right? We're going to get more than 3 diamonds, surely. 42 diamonds, my friends. This is going to go a long way towards gearing me up. And do you know what else is going to help us? Our villagers. We can get organized. And getting out of here will be fun, because as I walk across here, something might shoot me from behind. No, seems I'm good today. Now, my friends, we can get organized. And this is starting to feel more like it was last season. I love it when we get our ender chest full of shulker boxes, and just to begin with, I put all of my useful tools and things, and I've switched over to using my silk touch as our main one, so the ender chest becomes like a backup, and of course we got additional tools, additional ender chests, and all sorts in here. Key thing though, I brought with me some paper and gunpowder. I am prepared for getting our hands on an elytra today so that we can fly. This isn't look like anyone else has been here. Now, on every previous season of Hermitcraft, we've always had the shulker loot table adjusted so that you always get 2 shulker shells each and every time. This season, we're not doing that because of the potential to automatically farm these, so it'll take me a little longer to get my my shulker boxes together. Wow, that one dropped literally nothing. That sucks. And when you're floating up and you want to go down, use a water bucket, my friends. That's the way. So here is the loot from our first end city. It was a small one, and I've just found a second one right next door. The problem with this one is there is a bridge. Someone has come here and possibly just taken the elytra. And it's the Berkey method to fly without rockets, and then we found an Enderman farm on the way back, so that's been built on the server already. And with the XP from that, I have upgraded our wings with bending and unbreaking. And I was thinking, you know, maybe I should have skipped this whole getting diamond part, because you get tons of diamond gear when you're in the end. So if you roll the dice and go in there with iron, you walk out with like tons of fantastic enchantments, tools as well. I could have saved myself a lot of time by just going straight there. We also picked up a whole bunch of diamonds with a little clip here at the end. Added a safe and later on farm for the other players here on the server. But it was, you know, when working on that that I got chased by a bunch of pigmen out of the nether, and yeah, then this happened. So, I want to say a massive thank you for watching the video. Hope you enjoyed it. Be sure to leave a like and enjoy this little clip here at the end. Bye-bye.